as they spit the bathroom on the rainforest floor. But what they did eat was the sweet, juicy pulp that surrounded the bean that tasted like a white nectarine. Now, the Aztecs and Mayans, they weren't far behind with the discovery of chocolate. But what they did was create a chocolate drink. Now, what they did was they took those cacao beans, grinded it into a paste, added cornmeal and water to it. After they had that mixed together, they added chili peppers and spices to the top of their drink to give their drink a little bit of a kick to it. Then when they had everything mixed together, they put in this pot called the frothing pot. Now what this pot was used for was to create a froth on top. And how they did that was they blew bubbles to do that spout. That spout was not used for pouring, it was used for blowing bubbles into their drink. Now they believed that the froth on top renewed their minds and that the liquid renewed their body. Now cacao trees grow 20 degrees north or south of the equator. In the rainforest regions of Central and South America, Central Africa, and Indonesia, all those brown spots where cacao is being produced right now. Now in these pictures here, you see various cacao trees. On the far right, well, the last picture over here, you see on the tree are flowers. Once those flowers bloom, they then need to be pollinated by an insect. Once they are then pollinated, they fall off, and the cacao pods grow on the tree where those flowers once were. Now as you can see, the pods only grow on the trunk of the tree, but these trees grow to be 20 to 30 feet in height. They use the height of the tree to protect the pods from the hot sun. Now in this picture here, you see that the pods vary in shape, size, texture, and color, depending on where they come from. Now these pods can hold anywhere from 20 to 80 beans in one single pod. Now it takes about 400 beans just to make 1 pound of chocolate. So as you can see, we go through a lot of beans just to make all of our chocolate. Now you'd be surprised to see when we crack open one of those pods that those beans are actually white. And that yellow area is that sweet, juicy pulp that the monkeys would eat. So we scoop out those beans, we lay them on banana leaves where they go through their natural aging process called fermentation. After this process is done, we lay them on bamboo stick tables where they get sun-dried and roasted. This is where those beans finally turn brown and with a wonderful smell of chocolate aroma comes off of those beans. Alright, well we're going to go ahead and go on to the tasting part. So go ahead and open up your brown bag to take out your 5 pieces of chocolate. You guys should have a Hershey's milk chocolate, a Hershey's special dark, a dark chocolate bliss, the little yellow shark burger square, and a Hershey's caramel kiss. Now you want to go ahead and line them up on your placemats in their correct spots. This is the order in which we go in tasting of the chocolate. If anyone's missing any of those 5 pieces of chocolate, just raise your hand and we'll get you what you're missing. Or if your caramel kiss is much like a pancake and using caramel or rare, we'll get you a as well. Does everybody have all 5 pieces? Nope, one person. Got it? Okay. The bliss. Alright. Now I have one rule here in my classroom today, and that is we are tasting chocolate, we are not eating our chocolate. Yes, there is a difference. Eating means you're chewing with your teeth. We are not chewing our chocolate today. What you will do is you will place a piece of that chocolate on your tongue and let it melt. You can swish it around in your mouth, but do not chew with your teeth. Now the reason we do that is we have taste buds all over our tongue that depict different flavor notes. So the only way to get all those flavors in that one piece of chocolate is to let it melt and completely coat your tongue. When you chew your chocolate, you get the strongest flavor that is in that piece of chocolate. Like dark chocolate, you get that strong, bitter taste, and that's the only taste you get. When you actually let it melt, you'll be able to see that there are more flavors to dark chocolate than that strong, bitter taste. All right, go ahead and open up your water bottle. Take a sip of water. This is called cleansing your palate. Just get rid of any flavor notes of anything you ate or drank before you came in here. Now we will do this in between each and every piece of chocolate, that way we're all ready to taste
You don't like milk chocolate?
No. Go ahead and break a piece off. Of your tongue. No, you're starting off with a simple chocolate. There are not too many flavors that you will taste with this piece of chocolate. The main flavors you will taste are the three or four main ingredients that are in this piece of chocolate. Now you guys can look on your placemats. You will see a flavor wheel on there. Those are all potential flavors you could taste with chocolate today. Now I'm not saying you're going to taste every single one of these flavors in the chocolate. The main flavors you will taste are the main things that you eat in your normal daily diet. So if you drink a lot of coffee, you probably will taste a lot of different coffee flavors in these pieces of chocolate. What are we tasting with this one? Chocolate, yep, that's one main ingredient. What else?
Eggs.
Milk.
Milk, good. Sugar, good. And we might be getting one more flavor.
She ignored the eggs.
Butter, yes. This is what we call a finish. It's the last flavor note that you get right before you're ready to swallow all that melted chocolate. Now, not every piece of chocolate has a finish, and the ones that do is not always a buttery finish. We'll learn about a different finish in a couple pieces of chocolate. What do we think of the milk chocolate bar? Do we like it? Yeah? All right, good. You guys can set all your leftover chocolate to the side. We have to keep moving on. Make sure you do cleanse your palate, and then go ahead and open up the Hershey Special Dark Bar.
Cheers. Cheers.
I don't know if you guys know, but dark chocolate is actually healthy for you. It's high in antioxidants. And if you were to eat a regular size candy bar of Hershey's Special Dark, that's equal to drinking one glass of red wine, 2 cups of green tea, or 2/3 cups of blueberry. Now, like I said, this is a 45% cacao. The darker you go, the healthier it is for you. So we usually say to eat between a 60 and 70% cacao is the best range of dark chocolate to eat. Now it is all in moderation because unfortunately chocolate has calories. So if you eat too much dark chocolate in one sitting, you will get the calorie consumption, but you will not get the health benefits out of the dark chocolate. Now I want you guys to go ahead and use your flavor wheel and give me what flavors you are tasting with this one. Woody, yes.
Earthy.
Earthy, good. Sure, getting that bitter taste.
I don't know why you don't like dark chocolate. It's tobacco-y.
You're getting a nutty taste with this one?
Tobacco.
This one is still a simple chocolate. There are not too many flavors, not many complex flavors that you'll taste with this one. Do we notice, though, that bitterness goes to a little bit of a sweet taste as it starts to melt? There is still some sugar in this one. What do we think of dark chocolate? Do we like dark chocolate? Yeah, some no's. All right. For those of you who don't like dark chocolate, just hang in there with me. We have one more piece of dark chocolate to get through. And then I promise we will go back to a milk chocolate. But we're going to go a little darker and try a 50% cacao. Now the bliss is a thicker piece. You're not going to be able to break this one. Just take a bite out of this one and let it melt. Now the bliss is a premium chocolate. The first two candy bars you tried were mass produced. They only take about 7 to 10 days to make a batch of each chocolate. The bliss goes through a longer conching process. If you haven't gone on our tour ride yet, I definitely recommend you do the free ride. You sit in a car and you go through our simulated factory. You'll be able to see that conching process. And what it is a big metal vat that has our melted chocolate in. A machine comes through and squishes through that chocolate. The bliss goes through 96 hours of conching. The normal conching process is about 72 hours. So it takes 20 days to make a batch of the bliss. What are we tasting with this one? Anything different?
Onions.
Do you think it's more bitter or sweeter than the first dark chocolate you tried? Sweeter. All right, good. Some people might think bitter. Everybody's taste buds are different. What else are we tasting? interesting. Citrus, fruity, good.
Cocoa,
yeah, strong, bitter taste, good. I even get a winey taster. It might dry out your mouth like a red wine does. This one does have a wine finish to it. Let me think of this one. Do we like this one? Yeah? All right, good. Did anybody come in here not liking dark chocolate, but you kind of sort of do now? All right, I got a couple of you. All right, good. I did my job. Converted you guys to the dark side. All right, well, let's go back to a milk chocolate then and try the Scharfenberger chocolate. Now, has anybody in here ever tried Scharfenberger chocolate before? No? All right, good. Scharfenberger is a different type of chocolate. So we've started out with mass-produced. We've gone up to premium. Now we're ending with the top of the line with an artisan piece of chocolate. Now, artisan means it's handmade, hand-wrapped, and hand-stamped. When you open up this piece of chocolate, you will see Scharfenberger's logo of their animal is stamped on the front of your chocolate bar. It takes Scharfenberger 30 days to make a batch of these chocolates. Now, what Hershey decided to do was, instead of compete with Scharfenberger, why not buy them? So that's what we did. We bought them out in 2005. We do not help them make their chocolate. They use different ingredients like a whole vanilla bean and organic milk in their chocolates. So they make it all on their own in their factory in Robinson, Illinois. Then they ship their done chocolates here to us, and we help with the selling and distributing of their chocolates. What are we tasting with this one?
Fruit.
Fruity, yes. Creamy, I heard caramel, good. Milk, butterscotch, good. Might even get a hazelnut taste with this one. What do we think of this one? Do we like this one?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, good. Now this is the only milk chocolate Scharfenberger makes. They're 41%. They actually specialize more in dark chocolate. Their dark chocolate started at 62% and go all the way up to an 82% cacao. So they go up much higher than Hershey's. The highest Hershey's goes up to is a 60%. So they're higher than us with their 62. All right, well, we'll go ahead and go on to our last piece of chocolate. This is our Rule Breaker chocolate. It has a liquid caramel center in the middle. Please do not break this outside of your mouth. Just pop it in your mouth. You get to chew this one and enjoy this one. Now this kiss is in small tribute to Milton Hershey, since he was a caramel maker before he was a chocolate maker. When the kiss turned 100 years old, they came out with a liquid caramel center. Now it did start out as a seasonal kiss, so it was such a big kiss that we turned it into an all-year-round kiss. Now we have some seasonal kisses out right now. We have our coconut cream kisses and raspberry hug kisses out, so definitely check those out. Over the summer, we came out with a new kiss called our Mauna Loa Macadamia Nut Kiss. This is a milk chocolate kiss with a macadamia nut in the middle. If you haven't tried these yet, definitely try them. They are very good. Only Chocolate World is allowed to sell these kisses, so you will not find them anywhere else. Now, they are supposed to be a limited edition kiss, so I'm not sure how long we are going to keep them on our shelves. They have seemed to be a big seller, so maybe we'll keep them on all year round. What do we think of the caramel kiss? Do we like them?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, good. Well, that does conclude our class, and you guys have all passed with your master's degree in the art of tasting chocolate.
Master's.